2020, what a year. We hope you've all been good. If you're sitting comfortably, the story of Christmas can now begin.
Inside their chance of holiday sadly denied when Hancock called time on Christmas vacation and placed all the teachers in self-isolation.
It's 13 days and counting since the term came to a close, and the tension now is mounting as the pressure surely shows, and the only gift they hope for as they count the hours and pray is that Boris lifts the quarantine and saves their Christmas day. As CJ waits for Santa in her vigil on the roof, and Axel cups an ear to hear a jingle or a hoof. On the hill the fire crackles and the turkey slowly cooks, and Pledger sprinkles reindeer dust and shares a glass with Brooks.
We tried calling for backup from Chris and Sue J, but they're in the West Indies until New Year's Day. Public Health England left us enraged, sometimes no answer and mostly engaged. We emailed headquarters at IAPS, but there's nothing and no one that can clear up this mess. It's hard to be cheered when they've closed all the pubs, but it's lucky our teachers all run such great clubs.
There's river dance with Flatley and board games with Coomba. There's hockey with Stanley. With Joe, there's Zumba. There's Mrs. Mutherford directing Nativity and Lolly conducting with hyperactivity. If you want to spend Christmas in ward or on stretcher, then play our GB rules with our own Mr. Fletcher.
There's Wilson and Richardson slaying Sudoku, and Lendrum and Cuthbertson, both awesome folk who will physically challenge you along with Miss Sykes with cold water swimming and madness on bikes. And down by the tree where the castle will pass as Madeline crooning her stille Nacht.
Now in times of great crisis you have to stay cool. You'll find the best way there's in nursery school. When you're dealing with tantrums, nappies, and wee, you'll ask of a crisis, how bad could it be? Now Beth, Sam, and Laura are calming our wee, and Stenning counts days off her calendar tally. Wilmer's searching the skies for a light, and when everything's wrong, we all need stuff right.
In the kitchen, our Darren's a generous fella, but he shouldn't have opened the door to the cellar. The food's not been cooked, the wine's not been mulled, and brandy and shandy and fizz have been scum. As Debbie, Vicky and Helen pull red from the barrel to Jenny and Julie and Jenny and Carol. And Lynn starts in high now on sherbet and sherry, and sharing the last to the Baileys with Kerry.
If the kitchen is wild, then the office is feral. When Rachel sings carols, we know we're in peril. The internet's crashed and they broke, and the telly, and the smoke billowed wild from the fire set by Ellie. The network's offline and there's no sign of Cocket. He's fallen asleep, disconnected the socket. As Freeman pours lampshade souchong down the gullet of Rankin and calms a hysterical Tully. And it wouldn't be Christmas without the three kings. Ours don't come on camels, wear crowns and rings. They don't come from deserts, mountains or city, but they do bring a message, hot foot from Chris Whitty. As the clock it strikes 12 and the fortnight expires, it seems there's been mix-ups and several cross wires. The message they gave us, the briefing they shared, got all mixed up, should not have been aired. They never meant segregate, lock down or isolate. They meant to say celebrate, wind down and decorate. So Thomas and Thomas, get back to your folks. Kaylee and Bailey, it's all been a hoax. So come on now, Hollabone, throw open the gate. It's better than ever if Christmas comes late. And now at the end of this troublesome year, we wish you a holiday filled with good cheer.
Delighted to say that after an extraordinary year, they all lived happily ever after.